And our job is to understand literally everything that has happened, everything that surrounds that particular fuselage plug, and fix it and make sure it can never happen again.
I'm here in the spirit of transparency, and I'm here to take responsibility. So that's all for now. Thank you.
This is Dave Calhoun, the former CEO of Boeing from January 2020 to August 7, 2024. Calhoun's biggest mistake was failing to completely overhaul Boeing's safety culture even after the initial 737 MAX crisis. A door plug malfunctioned at 16,000 feet, revealing ongoing safety concerns within Boeing's production process.
An Alaska Airlines flight was forced to make an emergency landing after a portion of the plane blew off in mid-flight. Take a look at this. You can see what appears to be one of the passenger window panels missing right there. Nearly 200 people were on board that flight, traveling from Portland to Ontario.
Boeing, a name synonymous with aviation innovation, has recently weathered one of the most turbulent periods in its history. A series of high-profile incidents involving its 737 MAX aircraft has overshadowed the company's reputation. For decades, Boeing has been a titan of the aerospace industry, renowned for its cutting-edge technology and commitment to safety. However, the 737 MAX, a highly anticipated new aircraft, symbolized corporate failure. Two devastating crashes, Lion Air Flight 610 and Ethiopian Airlines Flight 302, claimed the lives of 346 people and led to the grounding of the 737 MAX fleet worldwide. Investigations revealed serious flaws in the design and certification process of the 737 MAX. A software system known as MCAS, designed to automatically stabilize the aircraft, was implicated in both crashes. Critics argue that Boeing prioritized profit over safety, rushing the 737 MAX to market without adequate testing and oversight. The 737 MAX crisis not only tarnished Boeing's reputation, but also had far-reaching consequences for the aviation industry. Airlines around the world suffered significant financial losses, and passenger confidence in air travel was shaken. Boeing faced intense scrutiny from regulators, lawmakers, and the public.
The American people, they're in danger. For your workers, they're in peril. For your whistleblowers, they literally fear for their lives, but you're getting compensated like never before. Don't you think maybe your priorities are misplaced here? I mean, don't you think maybe it's time to get back to focusing on making quality planes and paying your workers well and taking care of the little guys who got you to where you are? That's not a rhetorical question.
Senator, I don't recognize any of the Boeing you described.
During this crisis, Dave Calhoun took the helm as Boeing CEO. He faced the daunting task of restoring the company's reputation, regaining the trust of regulators, and ensuring the safe return of the 737 MAX to service. However, as the 737 MAX saga unfolded, Calhoun's leadership came under increasing scrutiny. While Calhoun worked tirelessly to address the 737 MAX crisis, critics argued that he was too slow to take decisive action. Some questioned his commitment to safety and transparency, particularly in the aftermath of the two fatal crashes. The 737 MAX crisis also highlighted broader concerns about corporate governance and regulatory oversight in the aviation industry. As the pressure mounted, Calhoun faced calls to resign. However, he remained steadfast in his position, citing his commitment to restoring Boeing's reputation and ensuring the safety of its products. He argued that he was the best person to lead the company through the difficult period. Despite his efforts, the 737 MAX crisis continued to haunt Boeing. In addition to the two fatal crashes, the company faced other challenges including quality control issues and delays in production. These setbacks further eroded public confidence in Boeing and raised questions about its long-term viability. In March 2024, after years of turmoil, Dave Calhoun announced his resignation as CEO of Boeing. His departure marked the end of an era for the company and signaled a desire for a fresh start.
Breaking news from Boeing. CEO Dave Calhoun will step down at the end of this year. Let's get to Phil LeBeau. He's standing by with Dave Calhoun. Hey, Phil.
Thanks, Joe. Dave, thanks for joining us here. You heard what Joe said, stepping down at the end of this year. Why now? And was this completely your decision?
Yeah, first of all, 100%. Why now? I've entered my fifth year. At the end of this year, I'll be close to 68 years old. I've always said to the board, and the board has been very prepared, I would give them plenty of notice so that they could understand and plan succession in regular order. And that's what this is about. It's me giving them notice that at the end of this year, I plan to retire. And then them taken the actions that they've taken.
Calhoun's resignation was likely influenced by a combination of factors. The 737 MAX crisis has taken a significant toll on his reputation and the company's brand. Additionally, the ongoing investigations and potential legal liabilities associated with the crisis may have played a role in his decision. As Boeing moves forward, it will be crucial for the new leadership to prioritize safety, transparency, and accountability. The company must learn from the mistakes of the past and implement robust measures to prevent future accidents. The 737 MAX crisis has left a lasting impact on the aviation industry. It has highlighted the importance of rigorous safety standards, independent regulatory oversight, and corporate responsibility. As Boeing navigates this new chapter, it must strive to regain the trust of the public and the aviation community.